Hey folks, welcome to the channel, welcome to the show. This is part 5 of Detroit Become Human. I hope you all are enjoying the playthrough. Thank you for clicking on the video and watching me play through it. I really appreciate it. This game so far is a lot of fun. I'm having a good time with going, getting further and further into the story. Hey, beautiful.
I hope
AI.
You had a nice experience yesterday. It's good to see you again.
Thank you. Now, you got anything to say today? No? Okay. Well, let me quiet down so you can enjoy the video. Here we go. Detroit Become Human Part 5. Thanks for watching and don't forget to click the follow button and subscribe to the video and visit my Twitch channel and YouTube channel. Links to both are on my Twitch homepage and can be found in the description below. Thank you. Let's get to it.
The most important thing is not to live, but to have a reason to live. That's a quote from Jean Genet, a French writer.
Continue. Here we go.
Alice. Wake up, Alice.
So it wasn't a nightmare.
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How do you feel?
I'm cold. What are we gonna do now?
That android we saw yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. The train passes just on the other side of the road. The station can't be far. You feel okay to walk a little? Let's go then.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
Police are on our trail.
All right. That's all for now. Ready to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you going to do with that?
I have no idea.
Took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Wait a minute!
We saw them headed for the train station.
Shoot! We need it alive!
That's insane.
Sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have
existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station.
I'm good. How about you?
There's some change.
Oh, yeah? What do you say? Really? Not surprised.
Apparently she did.
Yeah.
Thank you.
sorry. Excuse me.
Thank you.
the next mural here. I can't seem to find it, but I think I'm close. So just bear with me.
Welcome to Jericho.
All right, guys, I'm gonna call it here for today. I'll be back tomorrow afternoon for another playthrough, part 6. And I'm really into this now. Oh my God, that little jump scare that just happened. I jumped when I saw the android run across the screen in the book. Oh my God. I know you couldn't see it, but I figure out something to do with my webcam, I'll put the webcam on and you guys will see me here again soon. I just don't want to be tempted to talk over the video too much because it's for me, it's like a normal thing to do because I stream on Twitch. So I'm doing it for you guys, so you don't have to be staring at me, all concentrated on the video. I mean, on the game. Anyway, thank you so much for coming and watching the video, clicking on the video. Let me know what you think of the playthroughs in the videos as we go. If you want to, feel free to leave kind comments. No trolls, no haters allowed. Just kindness and as much positive criticism as you can give me. I will accept, will take a look at it all. And but I will see you tomorrow for another playthrough of Detroit Become Human, which will be part 6. Thank you, folks. Have a wonderful day. Bye.